News for Southern Nevada is now.
Everyone has that house on their block, the one with the nasty weeds, the boarded up windows, the destruction inside. Over the years, we've covered the sorry state of some foreclosures and the people who destroy the inside of these once proud homes. As the I-Team's Jonathan Humbert tells us now, that could become a crime.
Amelia Keene has never seen anything like it, and we haven't either.
Okay, then.
Yeah.
Keene is a realtor and took us on a home tour unlike any other, and it started with that annoying alarm blaring.
When the power's turned off, usually the beeping starts.
Trash, filth, flypaper, long forgotten, the remnants of a family kicked out because they couldn't pay anymore. The letter to Santa, seemingly ignored.
It's a lot of emotion here. There's a lot of anger. You can feel it almost.
Upstairs, just as bad as below.
Most likely we're going to have to remove the carpets because of the smell. We're probably going to have to paint.
The kids' rooms were worse.
We've seen the flies swirling around. There's that stench that gets in your nose and stings your eyes after a while. But the thing that's most disturbing are probably these kids' toys that are scattered around the house. This area was where the pets lived. We've got food and feces mixed in everywhere. It's tough to think about that kids and pets were forced to live in a condition like this.
It's sad because a lot of the items are children's.
Keene says treating a house like this is horrible. At other places, we've seen chunks taken out of the wall, missing appliances, and enraged owners taking retribution.
This is obviously a very angry home.
Keene's leery, though, of a law that could make this a criminal act.
I think the problem is how we're going to enforce it.
She wants to keep pushing cash for keys, the house stays intact, and foreclosed owners and renters keep their dignity instead of this.
Look, it doesn't have to happen this way. It doesn't have to be this traumatic.
You didn't hear us knocking? It's time to go. It's eviction.
Trauma is something Constable Sergeant Scott McWilliams faces every hour. He conducts multiple evictions a day, seeing the worst.
It's an unfortunate situation.
And they know it's coming.
Yeah, they knew it was coming.
Driving from foreclosure to eviction and back again, he sees the anger too.
They feel that they're owed something, I guess, after all the years or wherever, and now they're being evicted.
He says nearly one in four homes are gutted and destroyed.
I went in there and there was everything that was gone. The kitchen sink, the bathroom sink, the microwave.
Sometimes what we're seeing is that the things are left here on purpose.
Nearly the same situation back in our home tour.
Emotionally, they'd given up. You can tell from this, they didn't care anymore.
The loss of house and home, torn apart in rage that may soon be a crime. Jonathan Humbert, 8 News Now.
Assembly Bill 373 would make it a Category E felony for renters or owners who know the house is in foreclosure. That's prison from 1 to 4 years and thousands in fines. The bill was just introduced and has not been given a hearing.